In this class, we shall discuss about trick to remember statewise Raj Sabha seats allocation. So it is very easy and we can remember easily. Why? Because there are many questions asked from this section. So we need to find, we need to know this, we need to remember this, and most of the students will get confused with it. So you can remember these very, very easily by using this method. So first of all, let us give number 9 to Kerala. So Kerala ki number 9 allocation of Rajya Sabha seats for the Kerala is 9. And if you multiply with 2, means if you multiply with 2, it becomes 18 for Tamil Nadu. And not only that, for undivided AP, the seats allocated for Rajya Sabha seats undivided AP is 18. But after division, the Telangana is smaller state and Andhra Pradesh, in terms of population, it is larger state. So Andhra Pradesh has given 11 seats and 7 seats, total 18 seats for the undivided AP. After division, it became 7 seats for the Telangana and 11 seats for the Andhra Pradesh. Add 1 to this Andhra Pradesh seats, it will become 12. It means the 12 seats are allocated to Karnataka. Add the seats of Karnataka and the seats of Telangana, it will become 19 seats for the Maharashtra. It will become 19 seats for the Maharashtra. And remember that there are 11 seats for Andhra Pradesh. Similarly, Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, we have one more Pradesh, that is Madhya Pradesh. So that is the same 11 seats are allocated for the Madhya Pradesh. And the state that is adjacent to the Madhya Pradesh is Gujarat. The same 11 seats are allocated to the Gujarat. If you subtract 1 from this 11, it will become 10. So 10 seats are allocated to the Rajasthan. If you divide this 10 by 2, make 10 by 2. If you divide this 10 with 2, it will become 5. If you, for the Haryana, if you add 2 for the Haryana, it will become 7 for the Punjab seats. So there are 7 for the Punjab. And if you multiply the same 2 with one more 2, it will become 4 for the Jammu and Kashmir Union Territory. So the other one is Uttar Pradesh. Remember this, Uttar Pradesh, highest seats allocated for Uttar Pradesh is 31. Remember this 3. So Uttarakhand, adjacent to this Uttar Pradesh is Uttarakhand, it also has 3 seats, and adjacent to that there is a Himachal Pradesh that also has 3 seats, and Union Territory Delhi also has 3 seats. Remember this, Delhi Union Territory has 3 seats. And come to Andhra Pradesh again. Subtract 1 from this, it will become 10. So 10 seats are allocated to Orissa or Odisha. And divide this with 2, it will become 5 for Chhattisgarh. And add 1 for one more for the Chhattisgarh seat, it will become 6 for the Jharkhand. And add this 10 and 6, it will become 16 for Bihar. 16 seats are allocated for the Bihar. And add the same 10 and 6, it will become 16 seats for the West Bengal. And if there is a smaller state, that is Goa, one seat, and Pondicherry, one more union territory, has one seat allocated. And if you come to the northeastern states and Sikkim, remember this, this entire part. So Sikkim has one seat, they are the smaller states, and this is Arunachal Pradesh has one seat, and the Nagaland has one seat, and the Manipur has one seat, and the Mizoram has one seat, and Tripura has one seat, and Meghalaya has one seat. Add all these ones, it will become 7. Assam has 7 seats allocated. So this is very, very easy, and you can remember it easily. Practice this method 2 or 3 times, then you will become perfect. And it is very easy method. Share with your friends. you will get damn sure question from this section. And the union territories that has no Raj Sabha seats are Andaman and Nicobar Islands, Chandigarh, Dadra Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu, Ladakh and Lakshadweep. So these are the union territories that has no representation of Raj Sabha seats or no representation to the Raj Sabha. Why? Why? Because they doesn't have any legislative assemblies. So the members of Raj Sabha are indirectly elected by the legislative assembly, MLAs. So these union territories has no legislative assemblies. That is the reason there is no such representation from this to the Rajya Sabha. Exam point of view chala important. And like, share and subscribe, share with your friends and join the polity course. Such much more easy tricks and tips are given for your polity course, so which is taught for the group 2 geography, group 2 polity, group 2 geography, and group 2, not only for group 2, for AP and TSSI and group 1 polity course also. Thank you so much.